ED officials have arrested ex-finance minister P. Chidambaram and questioned him in Tihar jail in the INX Media case today. This is the same case for which the CBI court had sent him to jail on the 5th of September. Now, after the questioning in the money laundering aspect of this case, the ED has arrested the former union minister and is expected to produce it in court tomorrow to seek his custody. His son Karthi Chidambaram, meanwhile, has said that this entire thing is a meaningless exercise.
I came to meet my father. I'm entitled to meet him twice a week. So I've come to meet him as part of my weekly visits. He's in good spirits. And whatever these procedural games are being played are only being played for political theatrics. I've always maintained this is nothing but a case of political vendetta. There are no facts. This is a bogus investigation to continue to keep a former finance minister and a former home minister in some sort of custody for alleged transactions which apparently happened in 2006 is a charade by itself. This whole thing is only being played out for the vicarious pleasure of a few and for a voyeuristic television audience. I know what the ED does. I've been to the ED has summoned me 15 times or 20 times. I've lost count. I mean, it's a meaningless exercise. Perhaps they will do one more meaningless exercise.
Now, Prabhu Patel is also under scanner of ED. They are saying that.
I think you're only an opposition politician if the ED sort of pays attention to you. So it's a joke.
What we are hearing is that CBI will be filing the charge sheet in this week itself. That is, in the next 3 days, CBI will be filing the charge sheet in INX Media case. What we are picking from our sources is that around 10 individuals, more than 10 individuals and companies will be named as an accused, including former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram, his son Karthi Chidambaram, and also four of the then Finance Ministry officials, including Sindhu Sri Kula, who later became the CEO. In fact, government had accorded sanction to prosecute former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram in this case in February this year, and the government had also accorded sanction to prosecute four of the then Finance Ministry officials in September this year. So all these people will be named as an accused in the case, and even Peter Mukherjee will also be named as an accused. Another very interesting development is that when the Central Bureau of Investigation filed the FIR in 2017, they had named Indrani Mukherjee as accused number one in the FIR, but later she turned approver and the court had granted a pardon for her. So what we are picking from our sources is that Indrani Mukherjee will be named as a prosecution witness in this case. And as per the mandated law, that CBI is supposed to file the charge sheet within the 60 days of the arrest of an accused. So P. Chidambaram was arrested on August 21st. So that particular 60 days period is ending on Monday. So what we are picking from our sources is that Central Bureau of Investigation will be filing the charge sheet in INX Media case naming Chidambaram and others in this week itself, that is in the next 3 days or so. So coming to the Enforcement Directorate case, yesterday the special CBI court had allowed the Enforcement Directorate appeal to question and to arrest former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram in INX Media case. So after the green light from the special CBI court today morning around 8:30 a.m., Enforcement Directorate, three of the Enforcement Directorate officials reached the Tihar jail. And what we are hearing from our sources is that at this present time, Chidambaram is being questioned by the Enforcement Directorate. Very soon, the agency will be formally arresting him, and then they would be moving the special CBI court seeking custody of former Finance Minister.